I now give the floor to Mr. Khaled Khayri.
Madam President, yesterday the Islamic Republic of Iran transmitted identical letters to the Secretary General and to the Security Council stating that Israel has attacked the location of its diplomatic premises in Damascus by missile strikes, killing at least 5 Iranian personnel, including senior military advisors, and injuring others. There have been subsequent media reports today that the death toll has risen to 13, 7 Iranian personnel and 6 Syrian citizens. I reiterate the Secretary General's condemnation of the attack. Let me be very clear. The inviolability of diplomatic and consular premises and personnel must be respected in all cases in accordance with international law. The sovereignty and territorial integrity of member states must be respected in accordance with international law. The rules-based international order is essential for international peace and security, which this Council is mandated to maintain.
Regrettably, the Security Council has failed in its duty to maintain international peace and security. Russia proposed a press statement to denounce this atrocious act, which was backed by China, Algeria, and many members, but was blocked by the US, UK, and France. Faced with such circumstances, the Islamic Republic of Iran had no choice but to exercise its inherent right to self-defense under international law. Madam President, the root cause of the current situation are clear to all. From the start of the Israeli war against Palestinian people in Gaza, more than 34,000 civilians, two-thirds of them children and women, have been killed. All civilian infrastructures have been targeted and destroyed by Israel. Even humanitarian workers have not been immune from the military attacks of this rough regime. The absence of accountability and consistent inaction faced with the Israeli genocide and war crimes against the Palestinian people has only emboldened this regime to continue its violation unchecked. The US and its allies have blocked the Security Council for over 6 months, protecting Israel from accountability for the Gaza massacre. They not only avoid condemning Israel for these atrocities, but also actively try to cover up them. Their sole priority is supporting and defending Israel, regardless of the consequences and at all costs. Despite international pressure and UN Security Council resolution calling for a ceasefire, Israel has defied this resolution. Rather, its focus remains on committing more atrocious crimes, showing no regard for international legal obligation. Madam President, this lawless regime has committed many atrocious crimes against our people. This regime blatantly and openly admitted its responsibility for the terrorist and destructive operation committed against Iranian officials, scientists, and civilians, and sabotage against our peaceful nuclear infrastructure in recent year. This Israeli regime even made explicit threats to use nuclear weapons against a sovereign member state of the United Nations. This terrorist regime is responsible for all criminal and terrorist acts committed against Iran and must bear the consequences. The Islamic Republic of Iran has warned time and again about the repercussions of the malicious activities of the regime on regional and international peace and security. Iran has exercised maximum restraint. Now it is time for the occupying regime to bear full responsibility for its consequences. This regime cannot avoid accountability. Madam President, Israel's ongoing destabilized and irresponsible action and atrocities against the nation in the region are a real threat to regional and international peace and security. The Israeli Prime Minister's policy seeks to expand and escalate the conflict in the region to stay in power. The member of the Security Council must not allow such an august body, the Security Council, to be held hostage to the ambitions of such a belligerent regime. It is time for the Security Council to shoulder its responsibility and address the real threat to international peace and security. The Security Council must promptly fulfill its duty under Chapter 7 of the Charter in response to Israeli reckless defiance. It must take urgent and punitive measures to compel this regime to stop its genocide and massacre against the people of Gaza and uphold its obligation, especially fully implement the UN Security Council resolution and legally binding orders of the International Court of Justice. The main and long-standing threat to the peace and security of our region is well known to all, and the attempts to conceal it through disinformation, a smear campaign, or baseless accusation against others are pointless and unfounded. Iran is never seeking to contribute to the spillover of the conflict in the region, nor does it to escalate or spread the tension to the entire region. Contrary to unfounded claims, Iran has no proxy in the region. No individual, group, or country act at the Iran behest. The US and Israeli regime attempt to label the resistance group in the region as the proxies or terrorists. Their sinister aim is only to justify and legalize their malicious and destabilized activities in the region. The resistance group are not proxies or terrorists. They are legitimate and are only fighting against occupation and aggression of Israel in Gaza and occupied Palestine territories and of the U.S. in the region. International law recognized such legitimate rights against any occupation and aggression. Instead, the U.S. and the U.K. are fully responsible for all its decades-long aggressions and other crimes and unlawful measures in our region. Furthermore, they are responsible for all crimes of the Israeli regime, as it cannot commit any of such savage crimes in Gaza without the consent, order, and all-out political, financial, and military support of and a collaboration with the United States and the UK. We reject the allegation made by the Israeli regime at this meeting. Such false and unfounded claims don't merit to respond. Madam President, as a responsible member of the United Nations, the Islamic Republic of Iran is committed to the purpose and principles enshrined in the Charter of the United Nations, reaffirms once more its commitment to the maintenance of international peace and security. The Islamic Republic of Iran reiterates its consistent position that it does not seek escalation or war in the region, while warning about any further military provocation by the Israeli regime. The Islamic Republic of Iran reaffirms its unwavering determination to defend its people, national security and interest, sovereignty and territorial integrity against any threat or act of aggression, and to respond to any such threat or aggression vigorously and in accordance with international law. The Islamic Republic of Iran will not hesitate to exercise this right when required. Madam President, Excellencies, Iran has no intention of engaging in conflict with the U.S. in the region. We demonstrated our commitment to peace by exercising our restraint about involving the U.S. Army in intercepting Iranian drones and missiles bound for military target in the occupied Palestinian territories. This underscores our dedication to de-escalating tension and avoiding the expansion of conflict. However, if the U.S. initiate military operation against Iran, its citizens, or its security and interest, Iran will use its inherent right to respond proportionately. I thank you.
Following such a massive and direct attack on Israel, the entire world, let alone Israel, cannot settle for inaction. We will defend our future.
And we have a shared responsibility to actively engage all parties concerned to prevent further escalation.